We'll share it. We'll share it.
Thank you.
The town and up the mountain about 150 meters above sea level. Here you will be able to enjoy a spectacular view of the wonderful city of Bergen, also known as the capital of the fjords. Bergen was founded approximately 950 years ago by the king known as Olav Skyver. His name was taken from the word skyr, which in Norwegian is equivalent to the word calm. The people of Bergen, however, are not known to be very kiv. The duration of the tour will be approximately 50 minutes, depending on traffic. There will be one stop along the way where you will be able to stretch your legs and take some photographs of the city if you wish. You may also buy some refreshments at the kiosk, provided it is open. We wish you all a pleasant tour. On your right-hand side is a part of town called Nordnes. This is where the Bergen Aquarium is located. On the side, you can now see the shopping centre called Galleria, and on your left is another shopping centre called Exhibition. The street you are following is named after Bergen's founder, and it's called Olav Skyver's gate.
Diewold was one of the first factories in the country to get electricity in the early 1900s. The first light bulb that shone its light there can be found in the factory's museum today. Ahead of us to the right are five islands which today are connected with the mainland. With the help of three bridges and three underwater tunnels, the islands of Gordoi, Fiske, Valderoy, Vikna and Ellingsøy were connected to Ålesund in the late 80s. The tunnels are approximately 140 meters deep and up to 4 kilometers long. They were among the first underwater tunnels to be built in Norway. Now we've arrived at Fjellstua, which lies 130 meters above sea level. It was built in 1903 by the Navy. Originally, a wooden house painted red with white beadings sat here. It escaped the fire of 1904, but burned down some years later. It was rebuilt in the functionalist style. Has been remodeled several times. The last stage was the dome on the roof. Fjellstua is one of Norway's most visited viewpoints, and if you wish, you can walk down 418 steps to the city park.
Yeah, he wouldn't say the children. I know he wouldn't say children.
We're driving down Fjelltunvegen, which used to be the only motor road to Fjellstua and Fjelltun. The sharp turns made it impossible to get up there by car when there was a lot of snow. Klipka, where there is now an athletic facility, kindergarten, dental clinic, and a senior centre. In 1905 and 1971, City's Hospital was located here. Previously, all the houses in this area were painted a light brown colour.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for our Indonesian cruise show band. There we go. The Indonesian Coldplay. All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome to our very special show this evening. Oh my goodness, this place is packed. You have no idea what this means to our wonderful Indonesian crew. Now, before we start tonight, we do have a very special drink that's made in honour of our Indonesian crew show tonight. It's called a Rasa Sayang. And I was just talking to Aryo, who's our crew show director on the bass guitar back there, and he was telling me, you know what, local folklore says that in Indonesia, any man that drinks 9 of these, that every woman in the world becomes beautiful. Is that right? That's correct, yeah? That's correct. So I see a lady sitting down the front there. Would you like to have this? There you go. You know, it works both ways. There you go. There you go. Thank you very much. That's 7.50, please. Thank you. Just kidding. We know where you live. All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I would like to say to all of our British guests, thank you so much for teaching the Indonesian and Filipino crew some lovely little slang terms this week. They're all coming up going, lovely jubbly, and all things like that. So tonight we're going to turn the tables and we are going to learn something very easy in Bahasa, which is the language of Indonesia. And it means good evening, and it's Selamat Malam. Can you say that with me after three? One, two, three. Great start. Well, we are ready to begin our journey off to the beautiful islands of Indonesia. Now, I've got to tell you that these people are professional. They do this because they want to share part of their culture and part of their country with you. So please make sure you give them as much support as you possibly can. Now, we are going to start our show tonight by bringing to the stage a young lady that I know many of you are familiar with because she works up on the dessert line in the Lido. Always there with her. Yeah, some of you aren't playing that game, are you? She's got the ice cream, she's got all the desserts. She comes from the island of Bali, and she is here with our welcome dance. Please put your hands together, and let's welcome Trisha! Well, ladies and gentlemen, did you enjoy the show? Well, thank you so much for coming. As they say, thank you in Bahasa, terima kasih. Have a wonderful evening. Thanks so much for coming, and enjoy Flom tomorrow. Good night, selamat. Bye now.
They were birds. View to the waterfall Magnificent. Many waterfalls in Norway are manipulated by hand for water power, but Magnificent waterfall in Flåm is still natural and remains untouched. Inside, we can see the kindergarten of Flåm. Hans Fjord is an arm of the Sogn Fjord, which is the longest and deepest fjord in the world. National Geographic called out the West Norwegian fjords as the best travel destination in the world. And in the year of 2005, the Nærøy Fjord in the near neighborhood was added to the UNESCO World Heritage List. This is something the people here in this region are very proud of. Experience the peace and harmony of the West Norwegian fjords, there are many reasons to stay longer. We have some excellent hotels directly by the fjord. To the left, the Heimly Pension, and to the right, the apartments and cafe at Flo Marina will offer you an unforgettable holiday. This summer season, we are awaiting several bigger cruise ships here. The biggest cruise ship we are awaiting is the Queen Mary II. This ship is almost 350 meters long. Many tourists wonder how it's possible for such a big ship navigating here in this small fjord. But most of the West Norwegian fjords are several hundred meters deep. The mountains around this fjord are up to 1,300 meters high, and the fjord is almost 500 meters deep. Actually, the most difficult passage for such a big ship is where the fjord meets the sea. There, the water is sometimes only a few meters deep.
There's quite a few people on here now, considering that's the last one.
Seatbelt for that, no, that's good. Airbag. Airbag. At least you can take the impact.
Good morning.
Morning. You sleep well last night?
Sleep well? Last night? Not bad. You can tell.
Yeah. Intrigued. Too much last night.
Yeah.
That's the problem.
It's beautiful. It's beautiful here. Yeah. You will only drive slow.
You want 2-1-1?
That's fine.
There's a lovely girl.
Yeah?
Come here, my lady.
The whole trip takes around 1 hour. At first, we are going to the highlight area. It is unique cultural landscape and biking trail. The train turns around and rides back to the center and up to the library tower with the old stone church of Alfred. There we will have a short break of 10 minutes. We can step out and see the church from outside. From there, you can also visit the wood carver and Hadamard's collection
There you are. The entrance to the stairs is 20 kroner. And you can have a nice 10-minute walk back to the town.
Everybody has permission to put in the floor. Washed him away and he drowned. So rich Ragnar gave money to build this church to show her remorse. Here at the church, we take a short break of 10 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen. And of course, did you see the Indonesian crew show the other night? Absolutely fantastic. Some of the participants are here this evening, or this morning. And then here come your stateroom stewards, ladies and gentlemen. If you see your stateroom steward, give him or her a holler out. Tell them that you're here, support them. We've got a marvellous, marvellous zoo of talent animals here today. Everybody, well done, excellent stuff. Hello, teddy bear, very nice. What's that? A what? It's, oh, look at this. no cabin on board the ship that is getting service right now because everybody's here. All right, ladies and gentlemen, and of course right now we are going to bring into the stage our management of the housekeeping department led by our chief housekeeper, Tete, and his assistant, Rita. And also, ladies and gentlemen, the people that are responsible for your shrinking waistlines. Let's give it up for the chefs, everybody! Preparing over 13,000 meals a day for guests and crew. They say the average cruiser puts on £1 a day. Thank you, lucky stars, you're on a 7-day cruise, and not on a world cruise, 115 days. Also, ladies and gentlemen, the star from the Lido, working very hard for you as well. Our doorman there, the Canaletto star for here. I'm on the Lido from deck number 11. And the waiters from the Rotterdam dining room. Yeah, done a great job for you, thank you, the dining experience, fun back there. Evening in and evening out. Also, ladies and gentlemen, we have our wonderful bar star from the beautiful island of the Philippines, everybody. And also, ladies and gentlemen, we have our management Ariel, our cruise show director, Sarif, our dining room manager, our culinary operations manager, Florin, our wonderful, wonderful guest relations manager, Susanna, and her staff from the front office. Oh my goodness gracious, who's running the ship? Everybody's here. Our casino host Alex, our wonderful musicians from the Neptunes, our acoustic guitarist Philippa, we've got Rachel and the Hellcats. Our wonderful musicians from the Adagio Strings, Bogdan, Val, Avery and Robin, Glenn Michael from the piano bar, and of course the location team. Phil, your show host, Courtney, your librarian, Craig, your expert, our Culinary Arts Centre host, Sydney, and my event manager, Rachel. And ladies and gentlemen, this stage would not be complete without the stars of your Showtime Entertainment, the stars of our production show, Aces High, and an amazing show, Classy. Ladies and gentlemen, the Rangnam Singers and Dancers! Woo! Yeah! Oh, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, thank you very much. See, I made that for you during the D-Bart talk. That was really good. How you doing? You all right? Awesome. Well, ladies and gentlemen, these are just a few of the crew that are up here today, and I really hope that you have enjoyed their efforts in delivering an absolutely brilliant cruise for you. One more time, the crew are right there, ladies and gentlemen. Absolutely fantastic. And I tell you, you have no idea what it means to get those guest satisfaction forms into everybody up on the stage here today. So ladies and gentlemen, of course, you can see that there's just a small representation here today. You can see that we come from different countries, we different religious beliefs, different cultures, different backgrounds. When you come to work on board a ship like the Rangnam, there's no room for discrimination whatsoever. We live together, we work together, we socialise together. It's a great community. And we often talk amongst each other to say, you know what, it would be a great idea that if we could get some world leaders or some representatives of the United Nations down here to sail with us to see how we as a crew live together in peace and in harmony, maybe the world could be a brighter, safer and happier place in the future. One day, maybe. So we'd like to leave you with something now. I'm sure that you understand by now that everybody here on the ship come from different countries, speaks English in their own different language. But there is one language in humanity that binds us all together, and that is the language of love. And from us to you, ladies and gentlemen, this is our gift to say thank you. This is love in any language.
As the land from which they came. Lexington, the farmer loves his lambs, and daddy's old.